say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
And that was our national anthem performed by the talented Skylar Cole. And with that, we'll be right back in just a moment. It's that time of the year. Happy holidays, everyone, from 2K Sports as we get set to bring you some mid-season NBA action. I'm Kevin Harlan alongside Richard Jefferson and Greg Anthony, and with us from the sidelines tonight, David Aldridge. DA, take it away.
Well, thanks very much. Now, you know Giannis Antetokounmpo has one of sports' best nicknames, the Greek Freak. He said, when I first heard it, I was like, what's going on? Why am I a freak now? Then I realized it was about my athleticism and the things I can do. And so I embraced the nickname. I love it, and it's a part of me now. Kevin?
It's a terrific one. David, thanks. He does stand out. Wow. Here are the starters for Milwaukee. Giannis and Lopez hold down the post for him. Holiday and Allen have guard duties, and it's Middleton in at the small forward. And for the Nets, Durant is the four, with Claxton playing the five. Simmons is out there with Kyrie Irving, and it's O'Neal in at the three spot. With just about a half season behind us, the rankings are clearer than ever, Greg. You feel confident starting to make some playoff predictions?
Oh, Kevin, it's way too early for that. Injuries, other roster shakeups, there's just still so much that could happen and totally reshape those rankings.
Tip-off goes to Milwaukee. KD against Giannis. It's good, and he makes his first shot of the game.
And I really marvel at the touch of Antetokounmpo for his size and physique. That's incredible.
Now here's Simmons. The pass to Durant. Irving against Allen. Six to shoot. Lopez with the block. And it's Milwaukee's ball. Tough loss coming against Cleveland in their last game played.
And guys, there's really a fine line between being aggressive and being out of control. And in that one, they crossed the line.
They never settled in defensively, and it cost them.
Irving with it, and Holiday picks him up defensively. Irving, good.
The interior touch of Kyrie Irving, just superb at knowing how to slice through the defense with an array of finishes.
And after all the drama and wanting out, Kyrie Irving remains a net. Feels like a bit of a farewell tour, but winning can heal all, and you never know what the future may hold, especially with Kyrie.
Now Irving, after Chris Middleton missed from long range. Right side, Irving. Rebound, Milwaukee. Last time they met was in Milwaukee.
Well, last time out, they got the win in large part because of the play of their bench, and they provided a lot of the scoring punch.
And you can tell how important having depth is for them. Sometimes it's the difference between a win and a loss.
The Nets have gone 1-of-3 from the field to start this one so far. Durant, and it's sent back by Lopez.
It's a bonus whenever Lopez comes up with the swat. Want to see more of this from the big fella.
Glad we got the chance to see that remarkable rejection.
And making a statement right away, letting them know they won't get any easy ones when he's around.
Just about 2 minutes into the game, first quarter of basketball. Bucks have gone 2 for 4 from the field so far today. Allen finds Middleton. Over Irving. It's good from the top of the key.
I know what they say, defense wins championships, but you need some bucket getters too now.
Guys are looking for a spark here.
Yeah, a cold stretch offensively for sure.
A shot's good from Irving.
And once he got to the 10, I think he was surprised to find himself that wide open.
Easy possessions like that literally are just a gift. You just dream of them. He'll gladly take those.
For Milwaukee, they've gone 3 of 5 shooting the ball so far. Pass to Giannis. It's good, the assist that time from Holiday. Antetokounmpo's got his third basket of the night.
How about the effort? You didn't think a little contact would prevent Giannis from scoring, did you?
Looking at the last game for the Brooklyn Nets, it was a win against the Golden State Warriors.
Yeah, I mean, we saw them do a little bit of everything in that game. Showed a lot of versatility.
It really is fun seeing an offensive function like a well-oiled machine. I'll be interested to see if they can keep doing this.
Now here is Holiday. 9-point game his last outing. And that's out of bounds. Milwaukee will retain possession.
A tremendous defender. Durant's length can cause major issues for the offense.
Lopez sets a screen for Middleton. Just 5 to shoot. Free throw line jump shot. The shot by Holiday, no good. Nets trail by 4. Durant feeling it out a bit. That one falls.
It just looks too easy. Durant with the skill and height to get anything he wants from the mid-range.
And the Bucks are on a tremendous run here. The most consecutive playoff appearances since that streak they had back from 1980 to 91.
Now the dish to Irving. Back to Durant. It's tipped. Taken away by Holiday. .156 left to play in the first. For 3, Middleton. Rebounded by the Nets. KD's got 4 rebounds now tonight. Greg, and back to the Bucks. The question is, how much longer do you think is their window?
That's just it, Kevin. They've got the players to win now. And that has to be the attitude moving forward. They're built to do it again. Just need to push all the right buttons.
I'd like to see him a bit more efficient. He has not been great this quarter.
Giannis, that's a 2-pointer. And he buries that one, drilling the rim on the way down. Antetokounmpo's got 8. And the Nets decide to take their first time out here. And a whole new lineup here for Brooklyn.
A moment now to see the stats for Carter. How last month turned out for him? He's putting up 6 points a night, 2 assists, and 3 rebounds. Nothing about his numbers really jump out at you, but he'll come up with a timely play or two every game.
And that's what you need from some guys on the team. Not everyone can be an all-star. You need glue guys to find that success, too.
Nets trail by 4. We've got 1:13 left in the first quarter of the game. Here's Mills. That shot off. The Bucks go the other way with it. Here's Ingles. Carter outside. All alone. And misses it off the right side of the rim.
I guess even he has to miss one of those once in a while.
Here's Curry with the 3. And again, it's the Nets missing. We'll see if they want to trade 2 for 1 here.
Got to time up that clock to do so.
Pass to Connaughton. And here's Ingles outside. And Curry pulls it down. And the Nets shooting a pretty distressing 27% here in the early minutes. Passes to Mills. 15 seconds left here in the opening quarter. Left side, Warren. Tipped away. On the clock. From deep 3-point range, Giannis Antetokounmpo. He's feeling it tonight and has been the driving force for the Bucks. He notched 8 points in the quarter and has that terrific basketball instinct on display. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. And thanks again for tuning in. If you're just joining us, we've played through one quarter of action so far. And look what we've seen from Milwaukee. What do you think, guys?
What we saw in that first quarter, they won their matchups defensively.
Making it as difficult as possible for the offense to find clean looks. Great stuff.
And Brooklyn has possession. Trailing by 4. And Milwaukee, looking at who they've got. Carter out there with Pat Connaughton. And it's Ibaka. Then there's Bobby Portis. And it's Ingles. And at the 3, the small forward. And the shot by Warren, no good.
Look, the defense was locked in on him there. They know how dangerous he can be, and they guarded him perfectly.
Now the pass to Portis. The shot's good on the assist by Ingles. Portis has got the lead up to 6 now for the Bucks. Well, Greg, we see it every year. Those overachieving teams in the NBA. What enables them to be greater than the sum of their parts?
Well, listen, luck can play a part, but confidence is a huge factor as well. If you walk into that gym every night believing you'll find a way to win, oftentimes you do.
Now, here's Portis. And that one hits back iron.
See, that miss right there. It's why teams try to avoid the mid-range jumper these days.
Up top, Mills, defended by Carter. Back to Curry, the 3. Good on the triple. Curry's got himself going with the triple, his first basket of the game.
And not the tightest D right there. And he's going to punish you if you give him that much space. That 3-point shot is his bread and butter.
Now, here is Ibaka. Still getting warmed up offensively. No scoring yet from him. Here's Ingles. Count that one.
It makes up for a lack of speed with just tremendous effort and hustle on that play.
And so it's Mills who will bring it up for Brooklyn. It's a 5-point game. Warren, the pass to Sharp. Back to Warren. Pass to Mills. Clock at 6. Takes a 3. And again, Brooklyn with the triple.
When he gets a quality look like this at the perimeter, he can almost be automatic.
Carter kicks to Connaughton. Now the feed to Ibaka. Shoots over Warren. And he can't bank that one in. Brooklyn's gotten both of their three-point attempts to go down here in the second quarter. Pass to Mills. Second quarter of play with almost 3 minutes gone. Warren dishes to Curry. Brooklyn needs to get off a shot here. They get it again. Here's Sharp. Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot two free throws. Serge Ibaka picks one up there. And breaking down some numbers here, the hustle stats for Milwaukee.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
That free throw, no good.
Wow, what, did he have something in his eye on that shot?
Maybe. And a new group in for the Nets. Kevin Durant's checked in for T.J. Warren. Royce O'Neal comes in for Harris. Irving's checked in for Curry. And it's Ben Simmons in for Patty Mills. And he sinks the second. The Bucks have gone 2 of 5 from the field here in the second quarter, shooting 40%. Giannis inside. Durant's there. Outside, Antetokounmpo. 5 to shoot. Durant with the steal. Inside, Sharp, and then Sharp with the dunk.
Gives some love to KD there, making the unselfish play.
Just under 3.5 minutes played here in the second quarter. Antetokounmpo with the ball. 8 points for him. To the middle, here's Lopez. Good, and the assist goes to Giannis. Lopez has got his first basket.
And those are the kind of nice inside looks they've gotten here in the first half.
Brooklyn trailing. Now Kevin Durant. 23 points for him the last game against Golden State.
And defensively, he's been all over the place, wreaking havoc and pouncing on a number of steals.
The Bucks have gone 3 of 7 shooting the ball here in the second quarter. Giannis against KD. And Giannis gets it to go. Now it's a 3-point Bucks lead.
So strong. Giannis has really added some bulk since entering the league. Helps him absorb the contact.
Now here's Irving. And he's currently averaging more than 26 points a game. Such a force. And checking out some numbers for Joe Harris. He's made one and missed one so far in the game.
And from the line, he's knocking it down about 71% of the time, and that's a percentage that needs to go up.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
The free throw drops for Sharp. Hey, Richard, as soon as your playing career ended, you got right into this business, into broadcasting. When did you decide that this would be the next step?
Well, the first time is when I thought I was going to be out the league. And so I started doing more and more work until I retired in 2018. So it started way before I retired.
That laid the groundwork for you. Good job. And Holiday kicks to Giannis. And a lot of contact on that one, so he'll shoot two here. It's on Kevin Durant.
Maybe the most highly skilled big man in our league. Giannis is also one of the most frequently fouled bigs in our game.
Free throw good. Giannis. Nicholas Claxton's checked in for the Nets. So 1-for-2 that time at the stripe.
Something that's kept this game close is the fact that the rebound stats for both teams are almost identical.
Simmons against Holland. And out of bounds as the Bucks gain possession. With the All-Star game almost near, let's see how the East is shaking out. Taking a look at Milwaukee, earning the first place position with a terrific record. And we've seen them perform splendidly pretty much all season long so far, and they're definitely the team to beat. And, of course, Brooklyn, 2.5 games back.
And seeing where the Bucks are, they had a few critics coming into the season, and now I don't think they have any. This is a club ready to not only make a deep run, but possibly win it all.
Even though some people doubted them, there are just as many people, if not more, who believed in this team from the very beginning. And it's pretty clear right now who was right.
Brooklyn with the ball, following the shot by Drew Holiday. 6 on the shot clock. And he banks in the layup. Irving's got the game tied up here for the Nets.
The best shot maker in this league? It might just be Kyrie Irving.
And here's Holiday, who will bring it up for the Milwaukee Bucks. Pass to Giannis. Kicks to Lopez. He dishes it to Matthews. On the wing, Holiday. The pass to Lopez. Back to Holiday. Over Simmons. The shot by Holiday, no good.
And he rushed that one, no doubt about it. The D out of position, you could see the frustration on his face.
Magic with the rock. Kyrie just contorts his body, figures out ways to make the impossible look so easy.
The Nets shooting their 5th attempt at the line in the game. Milwaukee making a switch here.
One shot.
Free throw, good, Irving.
One of the most creative guards that we have ever seen. Irving is just so unpredictable with the ball in his hands.
And that'll do it for the first half, a competitive game so far. Nets out in front as they wrap up the second quarter with a massive 16-7 run. It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Thanks, guys. Here with Coach Budenholzer. Mike, your evaluation of the first half.
Well, I think both teams' defense is pretty good. You know, hopefully somebody can catch a rhythm here and score some points. You know, hopefully we can be better there.
Yeah, that'll be key as the game goes on, Coach. Thanks. Back to you.
Thank you, David. We'll be back after halftime for the start of the second half momentarily.
Thanks for tuning in. Did you miss us? Before we discuss the game at hand, let's first check out the upcoming schedule.
And for that game against the Celtics, Clash of the Titans. Going against the best team in the NBA, you have to minimize your turnovers, take good shots, and make big plays and big shots. That's a lot to ask, but that's what it's going to take.
And we look now at the Milwaukee Bucks. We got a battle out there after one half a play.
They've been pounding the ball inside, getting easy buckets in the paint. This strategy is diesel approved.
Shocking that one of the best interior scorers ever likes bully ball.
Because I'm the biggest, baddest bully ever, Ernie.
Thank you for being with us. Now let's send it to Kevin Harlan for the second half tip.
And we've got second half action for you. Thus far, a pretty evenly contested game. You look at Antetokounmpo really making a difference here.
The way he was able to finish on the block was incredible there in that first half.
The question now is, will the defense keep letting him punish them inside? Or did coach have some new ideas for them?
And in that first half, we saw a pretty tight battle. We'll soon find out what sort of adjustments were discussed during the half. Durant is the four, with Claxton playing the five. Kyrie Irving is out there with Ben Simmons, and it's O'Neal in at the three spot. That's the group for Jacques Vaughn getting going here in the second half. Bucks trail by five, and Ben Simmons, the epitome of a point forward.
He passes it well and plays huge for a guard at 6'11". It's crazy. It is very rare to see a player of his size with his skill set.
And here's Irving. He kicks to Simmons. Back to Irving. And that one, good. Irving's got the lead, back up to five now for Brooklyn.
Intelligent play by Kyrie. He knows the pick and roll gets him some better options.
Lopez passes to Antetokounmpo. Holiday against Simmons. Lopez sets a screen for Antetokounmpo. And there's the drive. A shot by Holiday. Nobody around. Off the mark there with the three-point shot. Brooklyn leading by five. Nets passing it around. Claxton the pass to Irving. Over Allen. Rebound Milwaukee.
And typically he has the touch to finish when he's in tight, but not sure on that possession.
Stolen by O'Neal. KD dishes to Simmons. Pass to Claxton. To the paint. And he elevates with a slam dunk, and Brooke Lopez did not like that.
Wow, and that sort of showmanship is just deflating right now to a team trying to get back into a game like this.
Ouch, Greg, that is definitely an emphasis jam, a big apostrophe or exclamation point, maybe even a question mark. So it's the Bucks now, following the bucket by the Nets. Allen outside, pass to Lopez. Now here's Simmons. A look at his stats. He averages a bit over 8 points a game. Durant finds Simmons. And denied. He sends it right off the glass. And it goes out of bounds. Last touch by Antetokounmpo. And we got to take a second look to admire that outstanding block.
And that block might serve as a spark for this team. We'll see if it can ignite them.
Brooklyn making some changes. Joe Harris has checked in for Royce O'Neal. And it's Seth Curry in for Ben Simmons. Milwaukee also making some changes. Serge Ibaka, he's checked in for Lopez. And it's Pat Connaughton in for Giannis Antetokounmpo. A little under 2.5 minutes gone by here in the third. So it looks like the Nets will retain possession here. Some changes for Brooklyn. Warren comes in for Kevin Durant. And it's Mills in for Kyrie Irving. Wesley Matthews checked in for Milwaukee. Carter comes in for Drew Holiday. Here's Claxton. Five on the clock. For three, Harris bangs home the trifecta. Harris has got the lead up to 10 now for the Nets.
And you can't give Harris any breathing room to shoot, especially when he's looking to fire the three ball.
Connaughton with a screen on Warren. And the Bucks miss again.
And that's the battle they haven't been winning today. Their work on the glass has been porous, and that's got to change.
Here's Mills. Harris with it. Outside Warren. Over Middleton. And the shot by Warren, no good.
You know, they don't score on that shot, but they're going to be happy with those kinds of possessions.
Middleton, the pass to Ibaka. It's tipped. Now, here's Mills. Defense is right there. Just over 3.5 minutes through the third quarter of play now. Warren kicks to Kerr. Count it. Good. And now it's a 12-point Brooklyn lead.
Yeah, they're going to have a nice little run here.
Now a timeout called by Milwaukee. And as the coaches go to the clipboard to outline their strategy during the timeout, the players getting a chance to rehydrate with some Gatorade. That's key to staying fresh all the way to the final whistle.
And, Kevin, it really is. And every one of these players knows it. They're all making sure to stay hydrated. It's impossible to play your A game if you're not getting enough to drink, especially towards the end of games when the physical toll of a long contest really starts to add up.
Edmund Sumner's checked in for Patty Mills. The Bucks also with the sub. Portis has checked in. Bucks trail by 12. Middleton outside. Over in the corner, Matthews. And again, the Bucks miss.
Yeah, that's a shame, because I'm not sure the defense will let him get a shot that good again very soon.
George Hill's checked in for the Bucks. And the Nets with possession. They're on an 11-2 run. Passes it to Claxton. Down low. And stolen by Portis. Harris against Connaughton. Carter outside. Back to Middleton. Uses the glass to finish the layup.
Yeah, Middleton is a talented scorer from anywhere on the floor. Goes to the paint and does his thing.
Sumner kicks to Harris. Warren against Middleton. Warren, the pass to Sumner. Clock is at 3. 18 feet out. Curry can't get it to go. Bucks trail by 10. They've been looking out of sync offensively.
Yeah, their offense has ground to a standstill. Strong move to the 10, trying to get his guys going.
Hard not to get motivated, GA, right when your teammate makes that kind of play.
And that could be the spark they needed to make a little run as they try to even this thing up.
Curry passes to Claxton. And here's Harris from the arc. The rebound by Middleton. Middleton's got 4 rebounds now tonight. 35 seconds left in the third. And oh boy, a lot of contact there, but he gets the call and will shoot 2.
And you see Middleton on the perimeter a lot, but he's really been trying to add strength to that 6'8 frame so he can mix it up a little more inside.
Shoot 2.
And No good on that one. Brooklyn making some changes. Ben Simmons, he's checked in for Nicholas Claxton. Durant comes in for T.J. Warren. And Thomas subbed in for Seth Curry. And Milwaukee with a change here, too. Antetokounmpo's checked in for Javon Carter. He hits the second from the line. Nets leading by 7. Simmons looking around. Twelve seconds left in the third quarter of the game. Thomas, a screen on Portis. Outside Thomas. Off target from three-point range. And so it's Brooklyn. Heading to the bench with a 7-point lead as we wrap up the quarter. And they've done a phenomenal job down low. So many of their points coming right at the rim. We come back right after this. How about a look at today's State Farm assist of the game?
And how about the big fella here showing us he's got some point guard skill here with the tremendous setup.
And for the defense, it's so tough to guard a big man with that kind of court vision and dime dropping ability.
The fourth quarter has arrived. So good to have you with us. And so it's Hill with it. He brings it up for Milwaukee. Setting the floor for the Bucks. Giannis and Lopez hold down the post for him. Hill is out there with Holiday. And it's Allen in at the small forward position. And it's Giannis missing. Brooklyn leading by 7. At the elbow, it's Simmons. And Simmons slams it in.
And at his size, all Simmons needs is prime time positioning. And he's golden. A fantastic dunker.
Holiday against Thomas. Outside Holiday. Allen outside. No good on the triple.
Yeah, and you could tell he thought that triple was going to fall.
Hill against Irving. That ball is good for another field goal. His 6th. He is 6-for-9 on the stat sheet.
A true wizard with the ball. Irving has some of the best handles that we have ever seen at any point in time in history.
Just over a minute played here in the 4th. Now Giannis. Dishes it to Holiday. Lopez, a screen on Thomas. And Holiday, here we go. And let's get your take, guys, on the scoring breakdown for Brooklyn.
Shooting 2.
The first free throw is good. The Nets making a switch here. Claxton's checked in. And Milwaukee also making a switch. Joe Ingles, he's checked in for Hill. Both free throws good from Drew Holiday.
Just solid. Really one of the very best there is at the free throw line.
Irving looking for an opening. Antetokounmpo pulls it in. Antetokounmpo's got 4 rebounds in this game. And it's denied. Outside Irving. And the pass to Claxton. And here is Simmons, defended by Allen. Count that bucket. And that's now 6 points for Ben Simmons.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
Here's Antetokounmpo, and Giannis throws it down.
And Giannis knows how to compete. He knows you got to fight for those second chance opportunities.
Just a little under 2.5 minutes have passed now here in the fourth. Simmons dishes to Irving. There's a good screen to the inside. Claxton, count the bucket, and he's got a free throw coming up as well.
And they are attacking the rim and getting great results.
As you go back and look at the last few seasons, RJ, it seems like team success has largely been predicated on health. Do you feel like that has always been the case?
I don't remember there being as many injuries early in my career, even with guys that were playing all 82 games. But you're right. Recently, we've seen a lot of key injuries. And look, this is my theory. Before, players used to get away from the game a little bit, take a couple of months off. Now players are staying in shape 24/7. Like, they never take a break. And I think that's why we might be seeing players break down a little bit more.
Yes or no answer. Too many games at 82 in the regular season should be less than.
Don't you ever ask me that question. Give me 82. I'd rather you bump it to 83 just to remove all doubt.
And I love it when Lopez attacks inside. Even with contact, he can find a way to score.
Stolen by Holiday. Rebounded by the Nets. Claxton's got his fifth rebound in this one. And Brooklyn with another turnover here. Chris Middleton's checked in for Matthews. Well, if you're just tuning in, welcome. We've got about 3.5 minutes gone here in the fourth quarter. To the paint. Here's Antetokounmpo. And again, the Bucks miss. And Simmons has got the ball here for the Nets. So far in the fourth quarter, they've allowed just 6 points. Here's Irving. Scores the bucket. He's 7 for 11 and continues to look good.
When it comes to the offensive end on the floor, there is one guy you can count on, and that's Kyrie Irving. He knows how to find shots and make an impact on that end of the floor.
Bucks trail by 11. Holiday surveying the floor. Here's Giannis. And he could not get that one to go. Out of contact, and he'll go to the line for two. It's on Kevin Durant. The first, and that brings them to within 10. And the Bucks making a change here. Portis is checked in. Free throws good from Antetokounmpo. Nets leading by 9. And here's Irving. Fires the 3. It's rebounded by Portis.
And even without that 3 ball dropping for him, the defense should have done more on that last play.
And it's Antetokounmpo penetrating. Middleton against O'Neal. Now here's Middleton. Tight defense on him. 2 on the clock. Brooklyn with the rebound. They've held a 12-point lead early. Pass to Claxton. to the middle. Outside for Simmons. Left side Irving. That counts. He's put up 13 shots, and he's had 8 of those go in.
And now as the clock ticks down, this is going to end up as a solid victory here for the Nets.
And it may be a comfortable win for him, but, you know, they had to weather a few storms along the way, and that's all part of the story.
Yeah, Kevin, this was by no means the runaway that it might appear to be. It was a scrappy performance, though, all the way through.
And I think a great job in positioning themselves for the W here. It's win number 21 on the season. And one of the key components to this victory, if not the biggest, was the incredible performance for Kyrie Irving.
And he's been a well-oiled machine on offense, keeping things simple on this end, getting the looks that he wanted, knocking him down.
Now Middleton, following the three-point attempt by Kyrie Irving. Middleton can't get it to go. Brooklyn with the ball. They have a 9-point lead. We've got a 9-second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. Outside Durant. To Simmons. Kicks it to O'Neal. This one for three. Rebound Giannis Antetokounmpo. Outside Holiday. And the three off target. So it's the Nets picking up the win. Even early on in this one, it seemed like they were happy to be playing at home tonight.
And it makes a big difference. Once they started to really play in rhythm, you never felt like they had any doubts as to whether or not they were going to win.
And now, let's check in with David Aldridge reporting from the sideline for our player of the game. David, take it away.
Thanks very much, Kyrie. It looked like you were in an extra crispy special kind of zone tonight. How did you do it?
The beauty is in the process. It's in the preparation. You know, before I get here, I'm trying to get locked in mentally, just trying to come out here and put on a good performance, lead my team, do the best job I can. That's all I'm trying to do.
It was all on display tonight, man. Congrats on the win. Back to you.
All right, David, great job. Thanks so much. And that'll do it, folks. This is Kevin Harlan thanking you for watching. As we leave you with our New Balance player of the game, Kyrie Irving.